The obstacles we face in our lives are sometimes indications that we are going in the wrong direction. An inability to achieve certain things is a signal that we shouldn't be trying to do those things in the first place. But in those moments, be rest assured that God is always there to guide you. He is always there to direct you and lead you towards the right path. Receive the grace to seek God's guidance for your life in Jesus' name. Amen. Now you may have tried hard to move on from someone in the relationship you have with them. But all efforts have proved futile. You have set up all kinds of boundaries, all kinds of mind discipline, and you have listened to all kinds of messages on how to move on. And yet you still find yourself drawn to that person in a positive manner. Emphasis on in a positive manner. Because if your inability to leave have adverse effects on you, then it could be the devil playing tricks on you and you have to ask God to deliver you. However, the basic truth you should know is that you can't move on from every person as a result of any slight issue. This is because there are really some people or relationships that you should still hold on to. If you have observed that you can't move on from someone, then God may be telling you something. Let me start by saying that there are certain blessings only that relationship can bring to your life. The truth of the matter is, God uses people to bless us and He also uses us to bless people in return. I believe you are aware of that. The devil knows that blessings can come through that relationship. So he sends those distractions your way to confuse you into leaving so that you miss that blessing. To receive the blessing God has for you through that person, you have to stay back. Remember that the Bible says that the blessing of the Lord makes one rich and adds no sorrow to it. Yes, that's the kind of blessing the devil is trying to deny you of. God may want you to stay back with that person because you hold their blessings in your hand, and you have not yet released it. Sometimes we try to run away from people who are of lesser influence than we are. But God still wants you to stay with them so that He can increase them through you and bless you in returns. If you fail to stay back, a lot of blessings will be missed. I know that's hard to hear, but it is the truth. Many teachers only teach about how and when to leave someone, forgetting that people also need to be taught about staying and holding on. God may be telling you that there are blessings in that person for you. So moving on can cause a misplacement of those blessings. Remember that His grace is sufficient for you. The reason you may want to move on may be because you are fed up with the person, or because the state of the relationship makes you want to give up. You may have been relating with that person in your own strength and it has led to frustration, and you are unable to move on. God is telling you that apart from me, you can do nothing. God is saying to you that moving on is not the solution to the dilemma you are in right now. Getting out of that relationship as you have been thinking is not the way out. Every relationship has its ups and downs. Even the strongest relationships have challenges. But God wants you to allow Him to help you make the relationship work. Every relationship has its rigors. Every person has a difficult side. But God is saying you should trust Him. Trust His grace to help you handle it without running away. God wants to show His sufficient grace in your life. He wants to give you strength in that weakness that is making you try to move on. You've tried every possible means to escape that person or relationship because of slight differences and challenges. But God wants you to hold on so that He can give you strength to handle the situation for the best instead of running away. He wants to display His grace and strength and power in that relationship. And so you moving on will alter that. God is saying, hang in there. My grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in your weakness. 2 Corinthians 12 verse 9. Remember, the best of that relationship is yet to come. God is telling you that the reason you shouldn't move on from that relationship is because the best part of that relationship is yet to come. God has great plans for you in that relationship. As it is written, what no eyes has seen nor ear heard nor the heart of man imagined, they are the things God has prepared for those who love Him. He also said in His word that His ways are by far different from your ways, and His thoughts are different from your thoughts. You are trying to move on too soon. You're still good with that person. You still have lessons to learn and missions to accomplish. You still have places to go and experiences to have with that person. You are trying to leave the race too soon. You are trying to walk away too soon. But let me tell you this. Just because things are rough between you two, and there's a kind of friction at the moment, it does not mean that is how the relationship will be always. You can only see as far as the tip of your nose. God, who sees the bigger picture, is telling you that there are still sweetness, love, and understanding that can still be experienced with that same person. Don't jump out of the pot before you are ready. God is still cooking something which you have to be patient enough in order to see what it is. Don't, because of the momentary misunderstandings, miss the effective and beautiful future ahead of you. Paul the Apostle puts it this way. He says, "For our light affliction, which is but for a moment, works for us a far more exceeding and eternal weight of glory. While we look not at the things which are seen, but at the things which are not seen. For the things which are seen are temporal, but the things which are not seen are eternal." So God is saying the reason why you can't move on yet is because He's still working something more beautiful and more permanent than what is on the ground that is making you think moving on is an option. So stop trying and wait for God. Remember, He has not yet ordained it. When God has not ordained certain things to happen, no matter how hard you try, it just won't succeed. The reason why you can't move on from that person is because God has not ordained it. God is telling you that it is not His will for you to move on yet. It is not part of His plan. Knowing that God's will for our lives is always the best. The fact that something is not happening is because God has not ordained it. The Bible says, "Who can say a thing and have it happen when the Lord has not ordained it?" So the things we find easy to do is because God has ordained it. Also, the things we find impossible to do is because God has not ordained it. If God wanted you to move on from that person, He would have made a way. But since you see no way at all, God is saying He has not approved it. You can't move on from that person or relationship because God has not ordained it. Always remember that it is not God's will for you to give up on people so easily. They will make mistakes that will frustrate you. But remember that you make mistakes too, and God did not throw you away. Romans 5 verse 6 says, "For while we're still sinners, Christ died for us." God intends for us to love with all our heart and make room for the excesses of people. The fruit of the Spirit in situations like this cannot be overemphasized. You can never be too patient. So show love and patience by staying to work things out. And as long as it is God's will, it will yield a positive result. Why not stop trying to force yourself to move on when God is saying these things to you? Listen to these things God is saying and watch out for the amazing things God will do. Let me tell you this. Ending relationships to find peace isn't the cure. Sometimes we need to call back the numbers we deleted. Sometimes we need to see that relationship therapist. Sometimes we need to fall on our knees and pour our heart out to God because the Father cares for us. It can be tiring sometimes to put up with a lot of things. But Galatians 6 verse 9 advises that you should not become weary in good doing. For in due season and proper time, you will reap a harvest if you do not give up. May the Lord help you in Jesus' name. Amen.